When you want to market a product, you dream about how you can bring it to the public. The best venue is the television show. And Arthur Murray was very, very fortunate that he and Catherine had the Arthur Murray dance party. And it was very successful for the attendees, the famous people who danced on it, and those who were part of the cast. The show had 11 seasons and 300 and some episodes. The show was set up as if you were invited to a large party and Catherine was the hostess. The show always started with the Viennese waltz and made you feel like you're in Vienna. If you were lucky enough to be invited to perform on the dance show, that week was your week to gloat and boast about it because it was a very fun party to be seen on. The show lasted for 10 years and featured many glamorous and celebrity stars. Altogether, the Arthur Murray Show featured 600 celebrity guest stars, more stars than you see in the galaxy. Billy Vaux was the casting director, and you were his choice of who you were going to dance with and who was going to stand on the sidelines. So if you wanted to dance, you had to be a good dancer and nice to Billy Vaux. On one episode, I got to dance with Whitey Ford, baseball player for the New York Yankees. He was not only a good dancer, he was very good looking and fun to be with. Above and beyond Whitey Ford, I danced with Norm Siebern, who was an outfielder for the New York Yankees. He was a great guy. He was controlled, composed, and he danced a beautiful rumba. And because of his height, who was so tall, he led me through that rumba with the greatest of ease. My dancing with Norm Siebern hit the newspaper. There was the headlines. He was musical, he was handsome, he made no errors, he danced with confidence and enjoyment, and I enjoyed every moment of it. If you want to hear a girl's heart throb, you have to dance with Ceasar Romero. Mr. Romero appeared on several episodes of the Arthur Murray Dance Party, and boy, is he a good dancer. When I danced with Ceasar Romero, we danced against Shelly Winters, Dick Clark, and Gloria Dehaven. On one memorable episode, Mr. Romero danced the tango with my friend Tad Tadlock. On one show, Mr. and Mrs. Murray had a hula teacher on their show. They were trying to teach the hula dance, and Ceasar Romero and Mr. Murray were in the front line doing the hula. Another one of my great memories is dancing with Zachary Scott. He not only was a handsome young man, but he was a great dancer. And at the end, he gave me an autographed picture of himself. I was assigned to David Niven, an English actor who was extremely good looking and very talented. Everyone wanted to dance with Mr. Niven. He had requested that he wanted a small, buxom blonde as a dance partner. All the blonde teachers were taken that day. They were assigned other partners, so I became his catch. I opened the door, and there was Mr. Niven looking at me, and I said, "Hello, I am your small, buxom blonde teacher. Am I not what you expected?
Oh, no, I just expected something rather different, that's all.
He went on to say, you're anything but small and blonde, but let's give it a try. And we got along brilliantly. Our dancing was featured on the Arthur Murray Show and in the newspapers. The celebrities were great, but so were my fellow cast members. One of the people that I danced with and enjoyed it very much was George Sardi. He danced with me at the studio as well as the Plaza Hotel. George Sardi is best known for dancing the Jitterbug with Maureen Stapleton. He was paired off with many fantastic dancers, and on this episode, he was dancing with Betty White. And then there was the exotic Beatrice Kraft, who danced an East Indian dance with Joey Bishop. And then there was Gloria Hamilton, seen here dancing the tango with Eli Wallach. One of the most talented dancers on the Arthur Murray Dance Show was Tom Hansen, who is seen here dancing the Charleston with Carol Channing. One of the fondest memories I have was appearing on that show with Jane Mansfield and Bob Hope. How famous can you get? There's a wonderful photograph of me taken on the set that day with Jane Mansfield. On one exciting episode, we had Johnnie Ray. Mrs. Murray loved him. She had him as a guest. And all the young girls in the crowd went crazy, screaming and waving their hands. Dream as you want, you young girls. That was all wonderful for the audience. But Johnnie Ray was having a secret love affair with a journalist called Dorothy Kilgallen. And nobody knew about it, but everybody really did. And so did Mrs. Murray. And now we're in the rock and roll era, which was not acceptable to the audiences of those days. Mrs. Murray did such a good job of introducing the king of rock and roll, Buddy Holly and the Crickets.
Now, if we're ready for our rock and roll specialist, we have Buddy Holly and the Crickets.
But everybody loved him and were crazy when he came on the stage to play his guitar. At that time, Buddy Holly was appearing in the Paramount Theater in New York and was a huge, huge hit with girls of any age, teenagers and grown-ups. Another time on the show, we had Mr. Sam Cooke, and we all danced the Jitterbug on that show.
Oh!
Episode, the talented dancer was Marilyn Best, who was selected to dance with the very handsome and good dancer Fernando Llamas. On the same episode, my friend Frank Hoffman was so lucky he got Arlene Dahl, the beautiful redhead, as his dance partner. They danced the waltz, and she was at the time Fernando Llamas' wife. And finally, on our dancing episodes, we had two people who were appearing on Broadway at the time, Farley Granger and Janice Rule, and they did a Charleston together. On one memorable occasion, Arthur and Catherine Murray were the hosts to Groucho Marx, who liked telling jokes and dancing with blondes. He danced with Deanne, he danced with Georgiana Margolis and Teenie Wilson, and he seemed to have had a wonderful time. Everyone knew Arthur's favorite girls. They were blondes. They were buxom blondes. And if you notice, all the blondes were in the front row dancing and having fun, and all the brunettes were in the background applauding and laughing.
Dance her by the toe. If she hollers, let her go. Eeny, meeny, miny, what I anticipated then.
You mean your mother didn't tell you what was going to happen?
Just a moment. My mother says that I should pick you. Something screwy going on here.
Tell me, you should know, is it true, do gentlemen prefer blondes?
Well, Katya, if they don't prefer blondes, I guess I've been wasting an awful lot of peroxide.
But tell me, Catherine, is there any way that we could find out?
Well, we could ask the men in the audience. Gentlemen, do you prefer blondes?
Yeah. And tell me, how many of you prefer brunettes?
Oh, it's just a tie, Carol.
Well, Catherine, it just goes to show you men can't make up their minds any more than we women can.
I appeared on all four networks, ABC, NBC, CBS, and Dumont. Dumont doesn't exist anymore, but they were all great stations to watch and perform on. I am proud to have been part of the golden age of television and have had so many fun people to dance with and perform with. I will never forget it, and it will always be imprinted in my memory. Talking about longevity, the show ran for 10 years, and it was fun. The casting was exciting, talented, and well rehearsed. Bravo, Catherine and Arthur.